Valve have released Steam Link so that you can play PC VR games on your Quest headset from your PC wirelessly and for free. Now, I know we've already got Air Link, but well, this one's actually good. So what's it like to set up, or how do you set it up? What's it like to use, and how does it compare to virtual desktop and Air Link? We're gonna cover all of that. So welcome to my tech gear. Let's get into it. And setting it up couldn't be easier. First, you need to go to your PC and install Steam. If you haven't done that already, go to steampower.com and go and install it. Once you've installed it, open it up on your PC, go into the store and look for Steam VR, and then install that. Now, before you go any further, make sure you go back into the Steam store and check out some VR games that you want to go buy, because otherwise you'll have nothing to play once you connect. There's a whole wealth of VR games that you can get, but I definitely recommend checking out Half-Life Alyx. That's pretty much the de facto standard VR game that everyone should play for PC VR, but there's other games as well. There's No Man's Sky, there's Skyrim VR. So just have a look around, get some games that you want to play. Once you've got your games all installed and ready to go, then it's over to your headset. Go into the store on your headset and search for Steam Link and install that. Now, make sure that the Steam app is running on your PC and then launch Steam Link on your headset. Now, providing that your PC and your headset are on the same wireless network, it will automatically find your PC. Click on that and it's going to give you a one-time code. You need to take that code and type it into the app on your PC, and that will automatically pair the two. And once that's done, it's going to take you straight into the Steam lobby with all the games that you've previously installed and ready to play. Just click on one of those and you're away. There are definitely some tips though that I can give you to make sure you get the best out of your PC VR gaming. First up, the settings in the Steam Link app. Now, I would probably leave most of those alone and just leave them in auto. The only one I would probably change would be the encoding size. Just bump that up a bit to around 1280. You'll notice then you get less foveated rendering, so that's pixelation around the outside of your screen. If you do find yourself stuttering on your network when you game, you can always pump it back down again. There are definitely a couple of settings in the Steam app on your PC that I would check. Do make sure in the Steam app on your PC that Steam VR is selected as the VR runtime and not Oculus, because that can cause some issues. And also make sure that you enable remote play. Next up is your router or your router. Do make sure that it is Wi-Fi 6 or at least a 5 gigahertz one. It doesn't have to be super flash. I've just got a mesh one in my house, which is a TP-Link one, and that's been fine. I would say if you do use a mesh network in your house, that make sure that you lock your headset to one node so it doesn't sort of roam around your house, because that definitely affects the quality of the signal. Now, whilst they do recommend that you play this with a line of sight to your router, so you're in the same room as where your router is, well, I'm not gonna do that because I don't think that's what most people do. I think most people end up with a setup where the router is in a separate room to where they play. So that's what we're gonna do when we play this, and we'll see how it goes. So I'm now gonna compare Air Link, Steam Link, and Virtual Desktop against each other to see how they perform. Now, the router is in a room next door and I'm gonna play in here, so it's a fairly realistic setting for what I think most people have got. First up, Air Link. Turn on Air Link. Click on my PC and select launch. Now that was quick, so that's pretty good. So we're now just gonna go straight into Steam VR. And we're into Steam VR. Now we're gonna have to wait for it to load. What was that? That's a bit of a stutter. Quest Link or Air Link definitely isn't the best. It does tend to stutter a little bit. Or can do. Seems okay now. So we're just gonna jump straight into a game. Into Half-Life Alyx. So we're now in Half-Life Alyx. He's seen better days. Hello. Half-Life Alyx is awesome. Not for the faint of heart. But it's a cool game. All up. For a really quick test, if I just wander around here, over onto the racetrack. Racetrack? It's a train track. Ooh, and there goes Air Link. This is why, what's going on? This is why Air Link definitely is, I think, the worst out of the three. So this is the only settings that you've got. You can change the dynamic or the Air Link bit rate to either dynamic or fixed. The only real change, or the only real settings that you can change in the app. So now we're going to test Steam Link. So go straight into your apps, scroll down to where Steam Link is, and then click on Start. Well, it automatically starts. Find your PC pretty quick, click on Connect, and we are now straight into the Steam VR Home Lounge. Is it me, or does it seem clearer? I think it's clearer. It doesn't look as jagged, the view, as it did on Airlink. So we're just gonna play Half-Life Alyx. And we're straight into the same game. So what I'm looking for here is the quality of the bitrate, quality of the image, so I'm not seeing sort of any foveated rendering, not really too much. He's still not looking great. Hi, dude. But we're not getting any of that weird glitching like we got with Airlink. Looking pretty stable. And if you go into the VR settings, which are here, you've got a lot more configuration options than you did over Airlink. So you can set the refresh rate of the screen, the render resolution. Steam Link allows you to set the different sizes. So encoding size, I've bumped up to sort of like 1280 up here if you need to. Otherwise, you just leave it on auto if you're quite happy with the screen as it is. So now we're going to try virtual desktop. So I've just gone into the study and I've started the virtual desktop streaming app on my PC. Now from your headset, head into your store, head into your library, scroll down and start the virtual desktop app. That's now automatically finding my PC and it's automatically connected. So I just press the menu button on the left-hand controller and I can go straight into games. Now it lists out all the games that are not only on the Steam store but also on the Oculus Rift app that's on my PC as well. So you don't have to go into the Steam VR lobby, you can launch your games straight from here. So it's gonna be interesting, with you watching this video, can you see a difference in video quality between Airlink, Steam Link, and virtual desktop? Don't know if it's just me, but this seems brighter. A lot brighter. I don't see some of that sort of pixelated, foveated rendering on the outside that I saw with Steam Link. Although you can change that by changing the encoding size, which I mentioned earlier. I don't know. Is it just me? Maybe it's placebo effect? I don't know. It seems clearer. Go up and see our friend Bob. Hey, Bob. So Bob's still there. He's not going anywhere. Could do with a manicure, though. I think it's safe to say that Airlink is definitely the weakest out of the three. Configuration options for virtual desktop are huge as well. If you go down to settings here, you've got lots of settings around auto connecting, which is what I happened with me earlier. You can set dynamic lighting and your audio size or how loud your audio is. You've got your environmental quality. You've got your frame bit rate down here of 90 frames per second. You set the bit rate. That's the only option that you had on Airlink. You've got even more options here. You go down to streaming, you can set the graphics quality and it's got guides as to which one's gonna be best for your graphics card. Now I've got an RTX 3060 Ti, so I'm sitting somewhere in between there and the medium setting for me was more than fine. You can set the VR bit rate, you can set how sharp you want it to be. You can enable VR pass-through as well. The synchronous space warp actually gives you a better connection than just a standard view. There's just lots of configuration options. For me, virtual desktop is still the most robust, flexible, configurable, wireless way to connect to your PC. It just does so much more than Steam Link does. However, Steam Link is free. So I would say start with Steam Link, and if that works for you, then you're good. If not, then go and get virtual desktop. As for Airlink, which is the official way that Meta allows you to play wireless PC VR games, I would say avoid it. If you want to check out some other ways of being able to connect your Quest headset to your PC, then check the link up here. Thanks for watching this video. If you have enjoyed it, please don't forget to like and share it. Consider subscribing if you're not. As always, see you in the next one.